Hey guys, welcome back to Skyrim, and in this part we're going to continue to explore False Scar. Now, we just previously exited out of Hjalmar Armory after rescuing the people at the docks, and we had to go back to Agnar, I believe. Now, at the end of the previous part, I believe we had a meteor shower occurring, but of course, I cannot see it. Which is a shame, because I think it would look good. Maybe I should do this instead. Just to try and clear out the aurora crap, maybe I'll be able to see it. This plastic candlelight doesn't help either. Which way are we going? We're going this way, I think. And we also remarked upon the additions to Falskar, in particular with the Hjalmar Armory, which makes the place actually somewhat decent, in my opinion. Why am I wondering? Why the hell does the Aurora Borealis keep showing up here? Maybe it's a scripted thing that just forces it to be here, because I don't think it really works, in my opinion. Too many auroras just look bad. Anyway, we have to go back to Aber Creek. And yes, I don't know why this is, but particularly on Falskar, my map goes really dark for no reason, but never mind. I don't think we'll have too many issues getting the next level, level 40. Why is it so cloudy here? Is it like a weather thing that with Falskar everything's got to be cloudy or something?
Hey, mister.
Hi to you too, I don't care about you. I think we'll get the end of this quest. Yngvar has mobilized an army.
His entire army? Then I am not sure what we are up against.
Well, why not?
Stalgard has had no reason to have an army for a long time.
But why is that? Tell me.
The last time we fought was just over 100 years ago. His family wanted the throne, and they attacked the Falskar and Amberholds.
Alright, okay.
The war ended with us, the victors, and his family put town in shame. They agreed to never try to gain power again. And ever since, it has been mostly peaceful here.
Well, until now. Well, so what does he want?
I am not sure. But whatever it is bad news for us. And he needs to be.
It's funny how Agnar says it is, or instead it's. But never mind.
The Jorgunnar family has served mine loyally for hundreds of years. All that's left of them are two brothers, Ulgar and Svegard. Follow the river east until you come to a stream. Follow that stream north, and it will take you to their cabin. Tell them that they are to resume their duties as my housecarls.
Okay, I can do that. It's easy enough.
It is not a statement. That is spoken lightly.
So if they've been told already that if someone comes along and tells us that on behalf of Jarl Agnar you've got to come back because you're to resume your position as housecarls, that means that... What the hell? That is just freaky. That is freaky as fuck. Like, wow. Oh, I'll just leave him to his weird fantasies. He must be on drugs or something. Maybe he's on Jet. If you don't know what Jet is, then don't worry, it is something from Fallout 4, which you will soon learn the meaning of when I do that let's play. Now what I find is silly is how it says here, follow the river east until you come to a stream that goes north. Well, the only stream that goes north is away down here. There isn't any streams up here that goes to those dots, but never mind. The easiest way to get there is just to run round here to the side and go across the bridge to the Amber Mine and then go up that side. There's nothing really to be found on the other side, to be honest with you, just the odd thing here and there. But never mind.
You're the one who came through the gate, aren't you?
Yes, well done. I like that the sun shining on the... I don't know why it's so glary with the lights here, but it works well with the water, I have to admit. That looks so realistic, don't you think? It's a shame it's a game, but never mind. Get that tip here and then wander through the overgrowth. And I believe there are a couple of enemies to be found. on the route here. Mostly just frostbite spiders, so it's not too big of a deal. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's no stream that leads up to this thing. If it is, it's not marked on the map. Just check it out quickly for dots. And there's the Jorgunnar cabin up ahead. Oh no, there is a stream. I didn't notice this. It's not on the map then. Let me see where I can find this on the map. Alright, so see this little dark discoloured patch just here? This is a stream apparently. I suppose it could have been marked better on the map, to be honest with you. But never mind. Here we are at Jorgunnar Cabin.
I wish Ulgar would stop hunting with his greatsword. It ruins the meat.
Why don't you say that to him directly?
Are you a hunter? If not, you should try it. Tracking your prey. Outsmarting them.
Don't care, you're resuming your duties.
The Unvalders are making trouble again? Very well. It was bound to happen sooner or later.
So basically you're saying that you knew this was gonna happen. Okay.
See you.
I don't think you can take anything from this place. No, it's all marked as steel. Not too helpful, and Lydia gets stuck in the way as always. Yeah, so all of this you can't take until later, probably. I'm not really sure where the path, that dirt path leads, but who cares? There's this stream apparently that leads you to them. I think it works out well having a stream, but at least mark it properly on the map rather than having it just a discoloured part on the map, because it doesn't work in my opinion when you do that, in my opinion. But of course, no updates coming to Falskar, you've got to wait for the community to give a shit. No offence, I'm not saying that the community won't care, but I'm just saying that until the community can work out how to make a patch, then or a mod or anything that can improve Falskar, then I very much doubt anything will happen. That deer went scooting off down there, I think. I'll meet you back at Amber Creek just to save some time. And we're back at Amber Creek, and it looks as if Agnar is now outside. I wonder what that's about. Oh, he's talking to someone, it looks like.
It's simple.
Oh, this is Ingvar, apparently. A lot of people have actually been asking to get Ingvar's armor, but you can only console command. I think it's quite ridiculous how we cannot get his armor. And we were going through very, very many versions here, and I really just cannot get it. I mean, why? Why can't we have his armor?
Or else what? Go back to Stalgard, Ingvar.
You can't get into Stalgard anyway, so it's not like a big deal.
Leave me and my
There's nothing there, it's just a ruin.
I'll be back, and you'll regret this. Your whole town will.
Got sick of Stalgard already? You're on vacation, are we?
Shut up, both of you.
No. Stalgard, Ulgar, it's good to see you two again.
Really?
Indeed. It has been too long, my friend.
How may we serve you, my king?
Svegard, we have been over this.
Sorry. How may we be of assistance?
It's like they know each other already, but how can that be? I don't know.
Ingvar is up to something. Big surprise there. He demanded to search the town, and has mobilized his entire army.
His entire army.
He is up to something for sure.
Of course he is.
I fear he may make a move on Amber Creek or Borwald. I think you two need to be here.
Okay.
Of course,
well,
I know.
Doesn't matter what we think because it doesn't matter. Game plot devices.
Very good. Then we must figure out what. Brother Thorwald,
he appears.
Have you decided to help?
Ingvar, that bastard.
What happened?
He came to the Priory, demanding to search the place. We let him search the main temple. And when he wanted to search the private quarters, Brother Colin stepped in.
Really?
His men simply killed him. And searched the place anyway.
So basically, Ingvar killed everyone anyway, so the Baelor Priory is useless. Okay.
We were to remain neutral until provoked. And Ingvar just hit the beehive with the stick. Wherever you need us, we sons of Shor will be there!
That just doesn't look right. It's like an over exaggeration, in my opinion.
I am glad you decided to fight.
Yeah, well, we're all glad you decided to fight. Stop being so neutral.
What could Ingvar possibly want? He tried to search the Priory and then Amber Creek. Why hasn't he touched a Borvald?
Well, that's where he's gone, I think.
Borvald. Either he has already been there, or he is headed there now. Jarl Varfred must be warned.
Oh, really?
I'm leaving your side. You're in too much danger.
Ulgar is right.
I must stay to mourn and to think.
That just leaves our friend here.
The Brayton.
I still like how that they've got the...
Very well.
The race dialogue thing is pretty good in my opinion, because it makes it more immersive that they refer to you by race rather than the Dragonborn or something like that. It's just stupid in my opinion.
Go to Borvald, the city on the plateau to the east.
If you say so.
It's been locked down due to the increased bandit activity, but his house guard should let you in.
Hopefully.
Tell him what has happened. We are on the brink of
the one
war.
Thing I have to say about Falsgard, that's never been improved, is the lengthy cutscenes that you have to listen to. They just go on and on and on. It's like as if, couldn't you not have just made them a bit shorter or less wordy? I'll go and warn Valfred then, I suppose. I think we'll get level 40 from completing an Army of Greed. Hopefully. Gain entrance to Borvald. So that's such a pointless quest. Just say enter Borvald instead. 61, and there we go, we got level 40. How nice. It's taken us so long to reach that point. You know, I'm just going to take that level right now just because. Magicka. And we have two perks here because I haven't spent them, which is not too good. That's the only problem, is where the hell do I put these perks? Because I have nowhere to put them. What's in this? No. Actually, what? Hang on. Nearby allies have... No, it's just pointless. No, I'm not interested in that. I'm really not sure, to be honest with you, where I put this perk. Perks, for that matter. Really, I'm not. Just gonna look around these perch trees for lock picking. Adventurous Pirate, that's just these words are just talking about torches, which is pointless. These two are actually decent powers, but you need like really high lock picking anyway. You would need to pick master locks near constantly to get that. Sneak I'm not even bothered with, don't care about it. Let's see what's in alchemy. Nope, not interested in that. Health regenerates 50% faster. That's a decent one. I could take that, but I don't know if it works. Because I remember taking that perk once before and it didn't do anything. So, again, I'll just leave the perks alone until I can find some use for them. Borvald is away over here, as you can see by the icon. We already pointed out before. So, I'll just fast travel to Hjalmar Armory and then meet you nearer to Borvald. Right, so I'm just having a quick look through my perks again, just to try and find out where I could put one of these perks in. I just forgot I could put it in this, because this has got, I think it refers to cloth, so like, things that don't have any armour rating on them. So I could enchant cloth items and get 25% more effective enchantment if I put it in cloth. So I could do something like, destruction spells cost 20% less to cast or something. So I'm going to take that. I think which will be useful because I haven't really gotten much into enchanting for a long time. I think it's been a 61 for quite a while. Well, 60. And I'm considering this perk, but then I realised I want this perk on the speechcraft. this one here long-winded, so I'll leave this pack, spend it on this, and then when I get to level 42, I'll put the next pack into the conjuration top one, the twin souls, and then that'll complete off conjuration and I'll never need to worry about it again. And then I can just focus on things like restoration and destruction permanently. So that's my plan of action. And you join me just as we're about to go up to Boar Vault. Just up here on the plateau, as they call it. This is the only time to get to Boar Vault, and once Boar Vault's destroyed, it's still not rebuildable, which I find is utterly ridiculous. I just cannot see how we cannot make Boar Vault rebuildable in some way. I also got an update from Helgen Reborn saying that updates are continuing, so good for them. There's a stable with no horse in it, which is hilarious. Let's talk to Gorin. I just want to talk to Valfred. Let me in.
Very well. I'll show you to Jarl Valfred. Follow me, please.
I know I could use that excuse to get in then.
Open the gates. Follow me.
Yes, sir. I find it interesting how this place is locked down and like there is just a few guards and citizens of Boar Vault around here.
Welcome to a fair
that you can't talk to. No one's selling anything. These display cases are just empty and everything is marked steel, but if you try to go to these doors, they don't open because there's nothing there. And I find it rather ridiculous how we've got all these versions of Falskar, and Boar Vault is still just a plot point area, which I find is utterly ridiculous in my opinion. There's plenty of use for this place, I can tell you. You could have shops, you could have a rebuilding mission, you could have lots of things here, and I find it ridiculous how we cannot rebuild the place. Oh well. If Melike wants to play that game, then so be it.
Then, what is it now?
I heard about the civil war in Skyrim.
Really? How did you work that out? You can't get to, you can't talk to people in Skyrim, so how does that work?
Y'all
never mind. Yes, he does. Quick save and enter. I think it's called Yalf Valfred's Manor now or something. I'm just going to single cast this because we don't need it for too long. Oh, he's sitting down this time. He's not standing waiting for me. Which is a change. Hello.
I'm Jarl Valfred. Is there something I can help
really?
You with?
Really? You don't look much like a Jarl to me. Yengvar's doing something.
I figured that's what was happening. I've had my city sealed because these damn bandits are everywhere and killing my people. It would be Yengvar. Damned Umvaldir's up to something again. Can't they just leave us be? You said he was looking for something. Do you know what?
Nope. He searched Bale and Pyrene and destroyed the place, and tried to search Amber Creek, apparently.
I don't like what this implies. I think I may know what he's after, but I don't want to jump to conclusions. Especially not this one.
Fine.
Jarl Valfred, sir. The city is under siege. It's the bandits. They've breached the gates.
Well, how the hell did that happen?
We don't have much time. Gorin.
Oh,
grab our weapons and let's go.
Already have them.
Yengvar has the nerve to attack my city. This is certainly the start of another damn war.
Good.
We have to go and tell Ivar. Yengvar's only desperate for power. So we did a lot of it. We have to get you out of the city so you can get help from Agna.
Okay, fine, whatever. Just let me out instead of these dragging cutscenes. Go. I'm going to wait for them to go outside first because I'm going to not do that, I'm going to sneak and then steal 3 gold from Jarl Valfred. I'm just going to have a quick look around here. I don't see the point of putting lootable items in here, considering that we never come back here. Never mind, let's save again and head back outside to deal with the bandits. I hope my frame rate doesn't get trashed like it was with Fraps. Let's just them. I can't see where the bandits are at. They're all just swarming. Do something then, Lydia. That's not what I wanted. I wanted Conjure Flame Achanak. I'm pretty sure that's going to cause a lot of damage. I don't see any point in me getting involved in this raid because of the fact. Oh god. I should. Unless a citizen of Borvald. Well, there's a bandit outlaw. Who's died? A bandit outlaw. That just came in wrong, I think. I will just not get involved because there's no point. I'll wait until they come attack me first because. There goes another bandit. There is. What is it? In a Borvald. Gold, lockpick, ring of recharging, and a silver necklace. Well, I suppose, you know. Some of these citizens do have some rather useful loot on them. Actually, there's a bandit marauder. I have to say, you get a lot of gold in lockpicks out of this. There's a bandit again. Who's there? There's another bandit. Now what are they attacking? Really? No, don't even bother attacking. Decast. Look, one citizen of Borvald survived, I like that. Never mind, let's just go over here. What are you attacking anyway?
Who's there?
Well, I'll just leave them to just kind of faff around doing God knows what, because it's clear that how this is supposed to unfold is not unfolding the way it should. I don't see the point of this climbing down farce, but never mind. Let's just cast and all the enemies are still here. Got a bandit thug who will die pretty quickly, I have to say. No, don't you dare. Oof. Close. I'll attack this thug and that flame attack, I have to say, is doing a hell of a lot of damage. So it's just a bunch of flame effects in the blocked off route, which is pointless. Die. That was a quick hit. And there's a bandit marauder here I can't see. And gold. Okay, so where are you going now? Come on. So why are you going up here? Come on, move. The game's damaged, yes, so can you just please move to where you're supposed to go? Wherever that may be. Instead of a way up here, come on. I want you to go to whatever the hell it is you're supposed to be going to. Which is down here, not anywhere else. Stop waiting and just move, for God's sake. That is just rather pathetic in my opinion, but never mind. Oh come on you characters, just fucking move instead of waiting so long. Come on, I want to get on with this. You're just dragging this out for nothing. This little piece of shit that you are. I'll just quick save again. Because they are so slow. Come on, run! Go in! God almighty. This is what we have to put up with, like this.
We have.
Shit. Get out of here! Well, Lydia, you're in the way of everyone here. You need to shift! Goodness sake. Why is it so hard to get these characters to fucking move? And I'm certainly not looting half these urns. It's just a waste of time. Come on, in you come.
I'll stay behind.
It's better.
But God, you can't just... No, 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 I'm trying to argue. go.
And he'll close the door.
Very well. Go, if we don't want his death to be in vain.
Yes, of course. So we've got to follow this prat who's getting in my way constantly through these catacombs. It's convenient that they're there, aren't they? I can just do this myself. I don't need you. Anyone in my way? Die. I'll just let him rush through. Come on! This casting glitch is getting on my nerves. God. Oh, shit. Did I hit Ralfred? No, I didn't. That's lucky. I thought I did, but I didn't. Which is good. Now, move. Not looting all this, not interested in the gold, just don't need it.
We have to get out of here.
Yes, you do! Don't turn around to look at me while I'm casting spells! Come on, it's not fair. It's certainly not necessary either. Quick save again. Right, come on, let's just do some.
Got a live one over here.
How many bandits are there? There's only two in here, it looks like. That's one bandit outlaw going flying. That looks like an Argonian this time around, which is interesting. I cast that and it glitched out again. I think I'm having a casting glitch issue. Can the pair of you do some death? God. These guys are so slow, it's unreal. I'm just going to activate that because I haven't activated anything for a long time.
Now, where was that door?
So obvious.
Here it is.
So obvious, the lever right there. How is that not an indication that's where the door is? Never mind.
Let's keep moving.
After I've exited this place, I will end the part. Assuming Valfred doesn't keep getting in my way. I just looted that just for the sake of looting it because I was waiting. It's a very slow runner, I have to say. I think this looks a bit different than it used to. Maybe I'm misunderstanding it.
What is that?
Colgrim, that's who he is.
You two are too late if you're here to stop me. The key is mine. Ingvar will get the heart of the gods, and he will rule all of you.
Oh, really?
Of course. The heart of the gods. Ingvar must have found it. That's what he's looking for. This
oh, really?
Is very, very bad. Come on, we must hurry.
Fine, whatever, I just want to get out of here because you're just wasting my time at this point. If you console command through there with TCL, you'll just see Colgrim just standing to the left of that bit, so useless in my opinion. Come on, move. I want to just get over and done with this and see how I'm waiting. I'll just deal with this bandit bug quickly. Ow. And now I'm stuck! Thank you! Get out! Shift! Jesus Christ. What is with these game characters being so crap? I'll just kill this bandit. And I will deal with that bandit outlaw. Like so. Now there's a bandit marauder. There he is, he's dead. No, they're not going to blow up this city. Because these barrels are just to make it look as if it's TNT, when it really isn't. Let's just try this, because as you'll see, it's just normal oil that they've put some barrels next to. They're not going to blow up the city. The game doesn't have the ability to do explosions of that nature. So come on, Balfred, move. Power lens shortly, it's just a bit longer at the moment because I'm wanting to. Come on. Why are you waiting? Oh, there he is, Brunei. Some distance from that door though. Let's progress through to back to the hold then. Let's see. Oh, where's Balfred? Nope. Okay.
This is it. The way out of here. Now go on, you have to jump. It's the only way you'll survive.
Okay, fine.
Tell Agnar that Ingvar's going for the heart of the gods. He'll understand. Now I'll hold these guys up for as long as I can. Now jump!
Fine. I don't know what that sound is, it must be from just above, but anyway.
Go on now! Jump!
Jump! Now I have to go back to Agnar. Just unlock this. Let me take the mask. And yeah. Yeah, pretty sure. Oh god, a wolf after me. Wandering around randomly in the pond. And I'm pretty sure the Lydia will join me. Nope, they are just kind of stuck on the edge. That's very interesting. I know Lydia's just over there. Flame Atrax just glitching out. Right, that's the start of this part. In the next part, we will head back to Amber Creek and tell Agnar what's happening in this place. Thanks for watching, see you later now. Bye.